So in the spirit of the holidays, I thought I'd be a little charitable, and I was thinking about a friend of mine who had a very, well, let's just say it's not the best home theater system. In fact, it's one of the worst I've ever seen, and I thought I'd help him out and do something special for the holidays and give him a really cool upgrade for his home theater. So basically, I was going to help my buddy Esteban. Like, I brought over a new to him, one of my older home theater receivers, a new 50-inch TV. He had a really ancient 40-incher. And basically, the Yamaha home theater that I've reviewed on this channel, just basically give it to him and see how, so just wait till it like blew his mind. His apartment isn't the biggest. I think it's, I would say, 800 square feet. Maybe it's under 1,000 for sure. So I would say 800-ish square feet. And so it's not the biggest. So this might be a little more than he needed. But I thought, hey, you know, if he ever moves and gets a bigger place, then he's all set for the future as well. I tried to capture as much as I could. I only had like a small window to be at his place to install all his stuff. So it's probably not the most detailed home theater installation, but I kind of capture the basics of it and what I went through, and I kind of, well, I hope you like it. I hope you learn something out of it. So that's the one. You said I can move anything except that ottoman right there, right?
Don't move the ottoman.
All right, Esteban, anything you want. Well, let's check out what you got for now. So we got a broken turntable, some pretty old, you know, there's nothing wrong with Polk Audio, so that's cool. They're decent.
Don't move the ottoman.
I won't move the ottoman. I remember, Esteban. I like the scarf too, by the way. Very nice. Tiny little center channel. I actually gave you these. I remember that. And there's the other Polk there. Oh, tiny little satellites. I gave you these two as well. But it's time for an upgrade, my friend. Let's see what you got going here. Oh shit, dude. That is insane. See, you even left it on. Wow, this is ancient. I gotta get a look at the back of this thing. What is this thing? I feel like Indiana Jones. Holy shoot. So you say it's not sold on Amazon anymore, this thing?
That's right. Esteban.
Esteban.
Esteban thinks it's not sold.
You're Esteban. By the way, I just want to point out, this doesn't even have LFE. This actually has speaker cables for the subwoofer, which is really, as you can tell, this is for like a home theater, a really old home theater in a box, and not a good one at that. So don't get this for 30. Don't ever eat. We're moving. This is why he needed an intervention, Esteban.
Woo-hoo!
Thank you, Esteban. You're a lifesaver. Do it, Esteban.
Esteban, where's my Jamo scarf? It's not like in Madrid.
We can actually eat here. Let's get it on a tall one. I can't see what I'm doing.
This is the top one.
I'm on the top one? Want to go down? Alright, let's set up some banana plugs here. Banana plug time. I'm gonna show you how to do one and then I will do the rest off camera, because that would be boring to have them all. All right, let's connect the first speaker here. All right, here you go. A few more. Here's the left, right. More banana plugs. These are monoprice ones. They're actually really good value. Yee. All right. Okay, so now I got the TV up on its new stand right here, and I'm wiring up the receiver over there, and so I just got a little more to go, and then I'm gonna finish up and see how it sounds. Okay, so I just finished putting the TV on its new stand, which is just high enough for the receiver to live next to it here. I'm gonna put the center channel down there. I mean, this apartment isn't very big, so there are space limitations. So I'm gonna put this the center channels right here in this corner right there, and over there as well. There's a stand over there you can see. So it's gonna be a little overpowered, but it should be pretty sweet when it's done. So I'm almost done wiring this thing. Hopefully we'll start plugging everything in and seeing if everything works. Okay, so I set everything up here, and now I'm gonna use the auto EQ and calibrate this thing. Almost done. One more run is what we gotta do. All right, well, we're done, man. This took a while, but I think it looks pretty good. Esteban, what do you think?
It's muy bueno. It's like in Buenos Aires.
Okay. Well, I hope you enjoyed, man. Sweet. All right.
I hope you found this video helpful, and if you have any questions about anything I did here, please feel free to leave them in the comments and I'll answer them as best as I can. It would really help the channel a lot if you liked and subscribed, and I'll see you in the next one.